truths in business. And those were some of my realities in getting started. If you have made the decision to go into the ministry of business, and it is a ministry, and it is a noble task, the reality is you cannot lose heart. Those are biblical truths. You cannot lose heart. You must make a commitment to give your very best. Keep going. I don't know about you, but I have had some days that I did not feel like continuing to go on. Keep striving with your very best. Don't quit even when you think you have nothing left. You have more in you than you really think. It will hurt. The burden will be great. It will seem you're about out of strength. It will seem too hard to go on. You will need a coach to tell you you can do it. You have more in you than them. Just when you think you can't do it anymore, look up. You just might be in the end zone. You're the most influential person in your company. If you walk around defeated, so will your customers, so will your vendors, so will your employees. You influence that. Negotiate with your body and find more strength. Did you hear that? That might mean you might need to lay down for a moment, get your grip, and get back in the game. Your very best. Your very best. And didn't Jesus do that? God gave his very best, his only begotten son. We have a role model. Your very best. Hold nothing back. Do not lose heart. In 2005, next slide, I started with a safe transition, developing the business plan for Impact Tri-State CDC. I was director of economic development for the city of Englewood, burdened by the fact that businesses in the city of Englewood were so frustrated that they couldn't access capital, burdened that there were not resources for small businesses, and decided to leave the city. With the same transition, I went part-time. I resigned my position. I went part-time, not just to start the business. I actually went part-time because I needed to be there for my children. I walked into my son's fourth grade classroom on a furlough day that I taken off voluntarily so I could be there with my child at least on Fridays at school, and realize that he, in fact, was not prepared for the tests that they were reviewing. And I knew, as wonderful as my husband was, that was not his responsibility. It was mine. I ran home and I said, honey, I'm going to resign. They offered me the opportunity to work part-time in a different position, and while in that position, I began the journey to start AMPAC Tri-State CDC. I had to start by doing research. I started by counting the costs, writing the business plan, evaluating, is this an option for the region? In 2005 to 7 is when I finished the business plan. Took a couple of years, and in that process, I was applying to the Small Business Administration to become a licensee. The people in the office that I had to apply to had not even read the regulations concerning a new CDC certified development company starting, because they hadn't done anything like that in 25 years. After we trained them on what the regs said, they had a number of different questions that seemed a little pointless. And when we finally got a chance, we said, why don't we just travel to Washington, D.C.? and talk face-to-face to the people who make the decision. So they peeled our application out of the box, which what appeared they had never even opened, but they were sending questions as if they did. That was so special. In April 2007, we received our license, the first certified development company approved in California in the Santa Ana District Office in 25 years, and the first and only faith-centered certified development company in the country. And our mission was to engage business owners who had faith as their center and to serve business owners in underserved communities where the numbers were dismal as it relates to accessing capital. In 2008, the market crashed. You remember that? I was calling a bank on the phone and they were saying, "I'm sorry, we're cleaning up our office. We got to get out of here. The bank is shut down." Okay, that's so nice. In 2009, I said, "Oh my gosh, honey, what have I done to our family? I need to find a job. This is not working out." And the Lord said, "No, you're not." And he closed every single door. And I'm very grateful for that because I lost heart and I was ready to quit. And my husband, who's the most wonderful coach, was right there saying, "Don't quit, don't quit, don't quit." And I want to encourage you, if you don't have someone in your corner who is your coach, look for her, look for him. Get your coach who can tell you, "Don't quit."